across Scotland.
From Glasgow
to Edinburgh.
From Shetland
to Orkney.
From Loch Tay
to Gaintry.
From Aberdeen
to Carnoustie.
From big employers
to small businesses making a difference.
Apprentices are working,
learning and earning.
I've got a job.
I'm getting paid and getting qualified.
I'm meeting new people.
I'm going to win a cup again.
I'm looking to the future.
And together,
we are bringing new ideas,
fresh talent,
and unlocking potential.
So join us
as we celebrate success
at the Scottish
Apprenticeship Awards.
Hello and welcome to the Scottish Apprenticeship Awards. Tonight's show celebrates the incredible work of foundation, modern and graduate apprentices across Scotland and the amazing businesses and individuals who support them. Now, our opening film gave a sneak peek of some of our inspiring finalists whose stories we just cannot wait to share. Honestly, they are brilliant. This is the 21st year of the awards, so a huge thanks to you for joining us and helping make the celebration as big as possible. Now, in a changing world, the role apprenticeships play in supporting employers and individuals to unlock their potential remains more vital than ever. Over the next hour, we'll shine a light on the outstanding work of apprentices, employers and learning providers from across the country. Our show will close with the all-important reveal of Scotland's Apprentice of the Year. Good luck to all of our finalists who have done amazingly well to reach this stage. Now, you at home can get involved by leaving a comment in our live chat and by tagging us on social media using hashtag ScotAppAwards. We would love to hear from you. But before we get underway, Skills Development Scotland would like to thank our generous sponsors for making the event possible. A huge thanks to Anderson Strathern, Arnold Clark, College Development Network, the National Manufacturing Institute Scotland, Scotland's Apprentice Network, the Scottish Funding Council, the Scottish Training Federation, Shell and SQE. Your support for the awards and Scottish apprenticeships is massively appreciated. We just couldn't make this event happen without you, so thank you. Now, to get things officially underway, I am delighted to welcome the Chair of Skills Development Scotland, Frank Mitchell. Hi, Frank. Now, the world of work is continuing to change, which makes apprenticeships more important than ever. Do you think that's fair?
I do think that's fair. I think apprenticeships are more critical now than they've ever been. The change in the workplace is actually speeding up, not slowing down. And apprenticeships work with real employers and real jobs, making sure what they do is current through work-based learning. And that means that apprenticeships are valued more than they've ever been before.
And of course, it's really exciting to be back broadcasting the awards show during Scottish Apprenticeship Week, isn't it?
It really is terrific. And I can't believe it's the 21st anniversary of these apprenticeship awards, which is testament to the value that Scotland places on apprenticeships. And isn't it terrific that we're online to make sure we reach as big an audience as possible who are really here to celebrate apprentices and what they mean for Scotland?
Absolutely, and this year's awards saw a big increase in nominations, which is a great testament to apprenticeships unlocking potential across the country.
I can't believe that apprenticeship nominations, which were already really busy, are up 20% this year, which is again recognition of the value that apprenticeships have with employers and the economy of Scotland. And it's really terrific that that amount of nominations is coming through. And the quality of what we see in these awards is absolutely fantastic. Every year I'm blown away with the quality of what we see through apprenticeships and the dedication of employers to support them. So I'd really like now to thank employers, sponsors and the apprenticeships who are coming here today to get nominated and hopefully wish everyone success for winning an award tonight.
Thank you so much, Frank. Now, to help present our first set of awards, I am delighted to welcome Scotland's Apprentice Network member and co-chair of the Apprentice Engagement Group, Kieran Pugh. Kieran, great to see you. Thank you so much for joining us. Now, am I right in saying you finished your apprenticeship a few years ago now? What did that apprenticeship mean to you?
Yeah, it's been about 6 years ago since I completed my apprenticeship. Essentially, it gave me a route into the industry, an industry that I was interested in, and now a job that I really love and enjoy.
And you're a big ambassador for apprenticeships as well. How important is that to you?
Yeah, I've had a really enjoyable journey throughout the last 6 or 7 years. And essentially there are still stigmas out there for apprenticeships in Scotland. And I really kind of want to give back and show that the success stories that are out there alongside many other apprentices that have done the same route.
So why do you think apprenticeships are so important for young people in Scotland?
Apprenticeships essentially offer a great route into an industry. It's a great opportunity to earn as you learn, essentially.
I like that. Earn as you learn. That's good.
And it's a great kickstart for your career.
Yeah, ticking a lot of boxes there, which is so important. But why do you think it's so important that businesses also get involved with apprenticeships?
Businesses are crucial because without their investment and their time and their effort into these programmes, essentially there won't be apprenticeships in there. So their support is, without them, essentially there are no apprenticeships.
Thank you so much for joining us. And actually, we're both very excited because we have got the brilliant job of kickstarting our first set of awards, which recognise the amazing businesses across Scotland who invest in Scottish apprenticeships. Our first award is for the Small to Medium Employer of the Year, which is sponsored by SQE. This category recognises organisations with fewer than 250 staff who have shown excellence in their support of Scottish apprenticeships. Let's meet the finalists.
The best thing about being an apprentice employer is watching apprentices come into an organisation with little confidence, and this is their first role, and see them develop and grow and actually being promoted within the organisation, and we have a really great success record of doing that.
Prior to joining, I did a lot of research on Multrees, and they've had lots of apprentices before, so you're in very safe hands. They're very encouraging, supportive. It's just a really good place to work.
You've got so much opportunity to grow, so you start kind of at the bottom and then you've got all that opportunity to grow and move through the ranks.
Multrees and myself are really passionate about entry-level employees and bringing more young people into financial services.
We've currently got 6 foundation apprenticeships and 12 modern apprenticeships. They're the new blood. They're the lifeline to continue the sector on its journey and be able to provide quality services in the long term.
I think the benefits of having apprentices is you're able to teach people, develop their skills, advance their knowledge, and basically teach them the full sector through your eyes.
I've done my modern apprenticeship here at HRM. I think it's great seeing people doing what I've done then to knowing that they could eventually, if that's what they're wanting to do, progress through the company. There's opportunities available. To any young person thinking about doing an apprenticeship, definitely do it, because I don't know the outcomes that you're going to get, and hopefully it'll change you.
The best thing about being an apprentice employer is giving people the opportunity to progress within the health and social care sector.
Apprentices do have an important role at Somerset. It gives them a broader view of what it is to work as a practitioner, as they work towards becoming a practitioner.
It's always new things learning, you're always learning on the job, you know, it's just amazing.
It's made me a lot happier, I'm happy to come to work.
I think it's good that you're training in a workplace, so you've got that experience with kids at the same time, so yeah.
Somerset Nursery use apprentices fantastically. It's the way apprentices are supposed to be used. They come in the door, they're bringing in fresh ideas.
It's priceless to see them as they develop and they grow, the new generation of practitioners.
And the winner of the SME Employer of the Year is Multrees Investor Services.
Our next category is Large Employer of the Year, which is sponsored by Anderson Strathern. Let's hear from the businesses who made the finalist shortlist.
I'm Aidan McIntyre and I'm the Apprentice Coordinator at GE Aerospace Caledonian. Within this business, we have 42 modern apprentices. As well as that, we also heavily support the Foundation Apprenticeship Work Experience and also employ 2 graduate apprentices. Throughout the 3 years apprenticeship at GE Caledonian, apprentices will develop a set of technical and meta skills to allow them to add value to the business for many years to come.
Best thing being an apprentice at GE Caledonian is, I would say, is you're earning and learning at the same time. So instead of going to university, I'm actually still learning and been on the job while earning money.
I think I've developed personally and professionally throughout my apprenticeship journey. I think throughout my apprenticeship, you go through different sections around the factory where I've gained confidence and developed my skill set.
I'm extremely proud to work for an organisation that takes apprenticeship delivery so seriously.
I'm Phil Brown, Head Early Careers and Skills at BE Systems Naval Ships. We've got eight warships that you can see in the background here, the most complex warships in the world, and to meet the needs of the Royal Navy, we need to employ apprentices.
I'm always enthusiastic about the calibre of young people we bring in. Young people coming in are more used to the technology now than people of my generation, so they pretty much, as well as getting taught the skills from the talent that's already in the yard, they're teaching the talent that's in the yard their skills as well as they're coming through.
I feel I've progressed very far, compared myself to where I was at the beginning to where I'm at now.
You meet a lot of great people and you get to know everybody, and kind of helps you become a bit more confident knowing you know a lot of people within the business.
I feel like I've developed, as it's gave me a head start to get my career up and running.
Our key learning providers, which are West College Scotland and City of Glasgow College, are absolutely fundamental to the success of our apprenticeship programme. And on top of that, the support that we've had through SDS and the creation of our National Progression Award is absolutely key to our business.
I'm Janice Russell, I'm Managing Director of McTaggart Construction. Well, we employed our first apprentice back in 1946 when the company was established, and it's been an integral part of our business since then. We like to encourage young people to develop their careers, and I think for us as a business, it's important for us to train people on the McTaggart way of doing things.
A good apprentice is someone that is willing to listen, maybe to go that extra mile. It's still a challenge for these folk, and it's about the ones that are up and ready to give it their all.
The best thing is they always give you the opportunity, and every time you need to go and see them and ask a question, they're always there to help.
The show and support that the company put in, the time they put in and the belief they put in, and it made me, you know, respect that and want to work for the company.
I feel like I've developed a lot during my apprenticeship. I think working part-time and doing uni part-time has helped to develop my skills.
Definitely do it, like get an apprenticeship, because you're getting paid and you're learning at the same time.
As a business, McTaggart Group will continue to encourage apprentices as we move forward.
And the winner of the Large Employer of the Year is McTaggart Group.
Our next two employer awards celebrate organisations who champion equality and diversity in their approach to apprenticeships. First up is our Promoting Diversity SME Employer of the Year award. Let's see which employers made the finalist shortlist.
I'm Angie D'Andrea, I'm the Support Services Director with TC Young. TC Young started employing apprentices about 15 years ago. Our modern apprentices are absolutely key because they don't stay modern apprentices. They come in, they learn the basics, and then very quickly we identify what they're interested in, what they're good at, and then we move them on to other departments where actually we feel they can fulfil their potential.
Being an apprentice at TC Young, it's a very friendly environment. I've been made to feel very, very welcome, and I've been supported throughout my whole journey.
I've only been here for a few months, and already I feel like I've been developing my confidence skills, and even people like my family and friends have already noticed.
Working with modern apprentices is without a doubt my favourite part of my job, and then seeing them progress within the firm, it's just massive.
My name is Donna MacArthur. I'm Director of Bovida Hair and Beauty. Bovida have always employed apprentices. It's crucial to our business, and we believe that young people are the future of any business, particularly the energy they bring to our industry. Equality and diversity is crucial, it's fundamental through our whole company in Bovida. We have to reflect what's going on in society in this day and age, and therefore we have to be really inclusive to make sure that everybody feels comfortable and welcome at Bovida.
It's been amazing being in touch with Donna and working alongside Donna and the amount of apprentices that she takes through, and she takes care of them all.
I've had a lot of support from Bovida, so much help with my confidence, the skills that I've learned, and it's just made me become so much better within myself as well as working with other people.
I think the training that you get is amazing, because when you go to college you hear about loads of salons that don't do in-house training, but we're amazing here and we do it weekly.
But if you are committed and you see them develop, it's life-changing.
I'm Rachel Backshall, one of the assistant directors at the Scottish Crannog Centre on Loch Tay. Equality and diversity at the Scottish Crannog Centre is so important, because by being diverse we attract diverse audiences. We're a young person guarantee employer, and we've also got disability confident employer status. We're moving towards leadership this year. It just makes it just better. It's a community rather than being a team.
Personally, I have had my own experiences in the workforce before. However, I've not found myself fitting in comfortably because I have an ASD diagnosis. Whereas at the Scottish Crannog Centre, I do find myself being able to ask for that support.
The support here has been amazing, very inclusive, so they've kind of taken me on and under the wing, and it's been amazing.
Kind of the diversity here at the Crannog Centre helps, you know, the customers feel engaged, seeing that kind of diverse people. It means anyone can feel engaged with what we're talking about.
I feel like I've developed my, you know, self-confidence. Before, you know, doing the tours and things, I was quite an anxious person, I would say, so it's definitely, you know, helped me a lot with that.
It's incredibly rewarding, just amazing to be part of.
And the winner of Promoting Diversity SME Employee of the Year is the Scottish Crannog Centre.
Our final employer award in this section is Promoting Diversity Large Employer of the Year. Let's meet the three inspiring finalists.
I'm Jessica Drage, I'm the Education Service Lead here at BAE Systems. So BAE Systems employs apprentices for a number of reasons, but particular focus is on investing in our future workforce. BAE Systems is committed to recruiting a diverse and unique workforce population. This includes bringing young people from a range of areas, a range of different life experiences. Their unique experiences and insight will help us build the best and brightest talent for the company.
The support from BAE Systems is uncanny. You get whatever you need, from hard hats to gloves to a new set of boots.
It's definitely changed my life. It's opened so many more doors, and I'm enjoying it. I wake up and I'm like, yes, time to go.
I'm quite badly dyslexic, so school wasn't for me. So I thought I'd go down the route of working, but also learning and earning at the same time.
Diversity and inclusion is so important in every industry, but particularly our industry, because there is such a stigma around working in a shipyard. And I think it's important we break down those barriers.
The council reflects every element of society. We've got young people right through to the elderly, men, women. We've got the absolute full range. It's really important we have representation from them so that we can understand from a personal point of view what these young people have went through.
It's really important that we are reflecting the diversity currently in society. We're really lucky we're able to do this through our apprenticeship programme as well as our pre-employability programmes that we have.
I'm very proud to work for South Ayrshire Council because all the work that they do helping equality and diversity, especially with disability sport, they give a wide range of opportunities to some places, to some people that really deserve it.
So that no one feels left out, and so that they're treated the same way, because if they're not, then it's not fair.
Quality and diversity is absolutely important to every business, and no more so to the public sector, which is what South Ayrshire Council is.
I'm Craig Bell, Chief Executive Officer of Bell Group UK.
apprentices are the be-all and end-all in our organisation. The way that we're set up and the way that our branch network is set up is all about bringing people from disadvantaged backgrounds or that aren't maybe given opportunities elsewhere or that have been overlooked, and making sure that we create an environment where they can prosper and become the best versions of themselves.
They're really great at getting equality running through the company because they're employing more women, which is great. I've definitely made a lot of friends here at Bill, which has helped me with my confidence. It's great.
Yeah, I've had zero problems with anything to do with whether I was gay or female or whatever. I've always had the exact same conversations that any of the other guys would have had with any member of staff.
For us, reflecting society gives us the edge. All them different ideas come into the mix, and it's all what we're about at Bill Group.
I'm incredibly proud of what we've created in our business. I'm incredibly proud of the mindset. I believe that we are setting the standard that over the next 5 or 10 years, everybody else needs to be achieving.
I'm delighted to announce the winner of Promoting Diversity Large Employer of the Year is Bell Decorating Group.
Huge congratulations to all four of our winning employers on your very well-deserved awards. And a huge thank you to you, Karen. So far, we've heard from the amazing businesses who invest in Scottish apprenticeships. Our next award focuses on the inspiring individuals who work day in, day out to support apprentices to achieve and progress. The Apprentice Instructor of the Year category recognises the outstanding support of instructors and mentors. Let's have a look at the finalists.
This category is sponsored by Shell.
Hamid Jamali, Esteem Training Limited. Since joining Esteem Training 2 years ago, Hamid has trained 58 apprentices. From supporting apprentices who are neurodiverse to helping those for whom English is not a first language, Hamid continually goes above and beyond to ensure he has the knowledge and ability to support the needs of each individual. Every apprentice Hamid has worked with has said that their confidence has grown and they feel far better equipped to positively progress in their careers. Pat McCaskill, Colinan, Elinshire. Former nurse Pat has been supporting people in the Western Isles since 1975 and is now focused on helping young people into apprenticeships. Pat's commitment has seen her travel by ferry, plane and road to deliver support to foundation and modern apprentices across the region. Working as an assessor and internal verifier, Pat has supported 38 apprentices since 2014. Inspired by personal experience, Pat has continued to develop her knowledge and understanding of additional support needs, which has helped her to tailor individual plans to the specific needs of apprentices. William Smith, Persimmon Homes. Before joining Persimmon Homes in 2021, William spent 33 years at construction body CITB, firstly as an apprenticeships officer responsible for the full cycle of the apprenticeship journey, then as area delivery manager. William has revitalised Persimmon's apprenticeship programme in Scotland, boosting modern apprentice completion and retention rates to 100% over the past 12 months. William's dedication to supporting the health and well-being of apprentices has also been praised with real business benefits. To date, William has supported more than 3,500 apprentices to achieve their qualifications and progress in their careers. And the winner of Apprentice Instructor of the Year is William Smith, Persimmon Homes. As well as unlocking potential for people and employers, apprenticeships and green skills also have a huge role to play in supporting Scotland's ambitions to achieve net zero emissions by 2045. Our Net Zero Awards, which are generously sponsored by the National Manufacturing Institute Scotland, showcase the great work that's being done by apprentices and employers across the country. Let's find out more about the innovative work our apprentice and employer finalists have been doing to support the transition towards net zero.
I'm Callum Gaw, a craft apprentice here at Spirit Aerosystems. I think it's important that businesses and industry tackle climate change because they have the ability to influence more than a singular person. They have the ability to reach out to multiple industries and millions of people. If they set an example, then everyone else tends to follow that example.
Really proud to see Callum grow within the company. He came into our department about 6 months ago. He's went to COP26. He's went to basically Dynamic Earth and influenced others. That's a big thing for me, is influenced others.
People nowadays, they think it's unachievable fighting against climate change or the climate crisis, but people thought flying was impossible. The Wright brothers proved them wrong. You know, it's going to happen. It's just, you need passionate people to do it.
I'm Megan Cooper. I'm a business admin assistant and I did a modern apprenticeship with Welsh. I think apprentices could help employers become more green because they bring a whole new viewpoint. It was quite surreal to be part of COP26, but it was a really good experience. We got to go up on stage and chat to the audience about our fuel change challenge we'd done previously. Booth Welsh gave me an opportunity to get involved and become more greener by offering lots of training.
I'm Hope Ralston. I work at Forthport and I'm an electrical engineer and I've just finished my modern apprenticeship. Forthports have really started going green. They've done like so many different things already, like reducing like the fuel consumptions by changing it to electricity. It feels good to know that I've made a difference in my role with the Net Zero Challenge.
So Booth Welsh recently reset their purpose, and today we stand for Through Collaboration We Want to Engineer a Better Future. And we really see our role as doing what we can to make those changes to our operations to be more sustainable by enabling and empowering our young people to get behind net zero as a whole and actually look at drive and action. I think is really inspiring, not only for our full workforce, but I think for the wider society.
So I think the role of employers in Scotland in tackling climate change and net zero ambitions is crucial because fundamentally we're putting people front and centre of this worldwide situation. So if the employers aren't doing anything about it, then you know who is going to?
Apprentices are involved in that transition to alternative fuels. They're at the forefront of that, involved from the very beginning.
Forthports placed the apprentices in a fuel challenge, which is to do with certain measures that the port can change to allow them to adapt for this climate change as such. So we brought in a new electrical van. The straddle carriers that we have are now on biodiesel instead of regular diesel.
I'm extremely proud to work for Forthports. We can all say we're committed to apprenticeships, we can all say we're committed to net zero, but I know Forthport really mean it.
Support in net zero is very important to our business because it's what we do. We are a renewable energy installers. We not only install renewable products, but we're going to actually be running from a net zero building ourselves.
Addressing climate change and promoting net zero isn't only important to our business, it should be important to businesses all across the world.
I'm very proud to work for a company that takes climate change and energy efficiency so forward, because it's something that's going to be very important in the future.
It's a really big issue and it's only going to get worse and worse unless companies cut down on their emissions and get to net zero.
We're continually developing our apprenticeship programme, working with Skills Development Scotland and UHI here locally to try and bring renewables more into the trade courses they have available.
I am really optimistic about the cohort of apprentices and next generation that are coming through. And the reason for that is once you engage and you empower this generation, then they are absolutely able to take that forward.
Wow, what an inspiring group of finalists who are all doing incredible work. Now, to announce our Net Zero Award winners, I am delighted to hand over to a very special guest.
It is my pleasure to announce the winners of this year's Net Zero Apprenticeship Awards. Apprenticeships have a crucial role to play in delivering the green skills Scotland needs to achieve net zero by 2045. The number of green jobs in Scotland is growing quickly, and every one of our finalists is an excellent example of the great work already being done by apprentices and employers across the country. I'd like to congratulate all the finalists. You should all be very proud of your achievements. Our first award is the Supporting Net Zero Apprentice of the Year. The judges had a very tough task, but have chosen a winner. This individual has been a proactive ambassador for sustainability, contributing to work that will reduce CO2 emissions and deliver significant energy savings at their employer. I am thrilled to announce that the winner of Supporting Net Zero Apprentice of the Year is Hope Ralston from Forth Ports. Congratulations, Hope.
It feels really good to be recognised in the Scottish Apprenticeship Awards, to know that my hard work's paid off and it's contributed towards the climate change and it's been recognised.
Up next is the award for Net Zero Employer of the Year. The winner of this category has mobilised their workforce around sustainability and is embedding net zero into the heart of their business. The winner of Supporting Net Zero Employer of the Year is R.I. Cruden. Well done, and congratulations to both of our fantastic winners.
To be recognised in the Scottish Apprenticeship Awards feels just incredible. Again, just for the company to be recognised with the work that they do with apprenticeships, promoting it not just in the Highlands but throughout Scotland as well.
Thank you so much for that, Minister, and huge congratulations to Hope and R.I. Cruden. We've had an amazing show so far and celebrated the work of some fantastic finalists and winners. But now we've reached our final set of awards. Yes, it's the Apprentice Awards. This is obviously a very exciting moment. And to help present these awards, I am thrilled to welcome back Scotland's current Apprentice of the Year, Jennifer Colonco from Coca-Cola Euro-Pacific Partners. Jennifer, it is so good to see you. I cannot believe that has been almost a full year since we surprised you to let you know you were Scotland's Apprentice of the Year. What was that moment like for you?
It was a shock, and I feel very privileged to have been given the award.
Winning that award, obviously brilliant, but what did it mean to you to be an apprentice itself?
It made me feel really proud. It's a great privilege to have been an apprentice, and it's turned from a hobby into a career now, and I look forward to promoting further apprenticeships.
Was there a highlight over the years of your apprenticeship?
Just learning all new skills and gaining more knowledge, and it's now a privilege that I can pass my knowledge on to future apprentices. So now I have an apprentice that works under me through my shifts, and I'm passing my knowledge on to them.
Yeah, that must be quite special actually, like a full circle to go there and now be helping other people. How does it feel being the teacher?
It's a good role reversal. It's great to pass my knowledge down, and hopefully they'll do the same when it's their turn to pass their knowledge on.
Fantastic. It is so great to see you, and you're going to help us reveal some of the winners as well. Now, coming up, we have got the Ambassador Award, which recognises former apprentices who continue to champion and promote work-based learning. We'll then go on to present four awards recognising the impact of foundation, modern and graduate apprentices across the country. And then finally, we have the grand finale as we announce the overall award for Scotland's Apprentice of the Year. They're going to be taking your crown, which could be given to any one of our foundation, modern or graduate apprentice winners. So make sure you stay tuned for the big reveal. It's going to be a good one. And if you've got a good luck message or a congratulations message to share, please remember to get involved. You can leave a comment in the live chat or tag us on social media using hashtag ScotAppAwards. Our first award is Apprentice Ambassador of the Year. This category spotlights former apprentices whose ongoing work encourages and supports others onto the apprenticeship career path. This category is generously sponsored by Arnold Clark. Let's meet the finalists.
My name is Ethan O'Hare, and I am an apprentice chef at the Week at Kitchen in Barry Downs. I've just finished my first apprenticeship and doing my second apprenticeship just now. I left school early to work in a local cafe just cleaning dishes, and left school with nothing at all really, and just so happened to work my way up in the kitchen, and that's where I am today now, so I'm grateful.
Ethan's our apprentice. He's just about to finish his apprentice. He's been with us a few years now, and he's going to be our sous chef. We've just promoted him recently. Great guy. What we've seen is he's gained in confidence to the point that he can run front of house on his own. So he finished his hospitality apprenticeship and then wanted to do the kitchen because he'd shown aptitude in that as well. But he's also developed his teamwork and leadership skills.
I'm excited to see what else the world holds for me after my apprenticeships.
I'm Ewan McLean. I'm a project engineer in the process and energy sector for Altrad Babcock. I completed a modern technical apprenticeship in engineering technical support as part of the asset management function. During my apprenticeship, I took on a lot of engineering coordination roles, primarily in asset management inspection at first, but in my current career, that's now what I've taken into engineering, procurement and construction projects as the engineering management role to coordinate design. Apprentices are important because the country has a lot of ambitious projects and sustainability goals that can only be achieved by a developing workforce at the moment. It's really important that we train people, we invest in people.
I feel really proud of Ewan for being a great ambassador for apprenticeships. His attitude and his approach to the apprenticeship scheme has been very professional and is a prime exemplar of what we would expect from an apprentice.
To sum my apprenticeship up in three words, I would say proud, accomplished and confident.
I'm Declan Hoskins. My job title is the third in charge at Bright Horizons RGU in Aberdeen. I completed a modern apprenticeship in social services, children and young people in 2018. What I always wanted to do was go ahead and work with children, whether it be through early years, whether it be primary school. I wasn't too sure what I wanted to do, so completing the modern apprenticeship definitely opened my eyes into what exactly I wanted to do. I think my passion for helping apprentices is having the realisation of where I was and where I am now, and how much of an impact one person can have. If I'm helping shape an apprentice, I'm helping shape people in the long run, whether it be children or whether it be themselves.
He's gone from strength to strength. He's built his confidence, he's increased his knowledge. He's become much more comfortable as to who he is as a practitioner. I feel it's been a joy for me to be part of his career.
It's kind of like a heartfelt feeling that knowing that you're doing something right. You're not just coming here and not doing anything. You're making an impact somewhere.
I'm delighted to announce that the winner of Apprentice Ambassador of the Year is Declan Hoskins.
To be recognised in the Scottish Apprenticeship Awards it's overwhelming. It makes me feel that I've had an impact somewhere, appreciated, valued. It's just joyous.
Our next apprentice category is the Foundation Apprentice of the Year, which is sponsored by College Development Network. Across Scotland, thousands of school pupils are getting set for a big future by selecting a foundation apprenticeship as one of their subject choices. Let's meet our three foundation apprentice finalists.
My name is Katie Fenn. Last year, I did foundation apprenticeship as one of my SS courses. Sometimes when I first meet people, I don't understand them. So I think that's a bigger challenge for me. By doing that, it helps me to bounce confident.
Katie is just absolutely full of life. She's completely passionate about childcare, and we knew that from the minute that we met Katie. She worked with children who are deaf, but also with hearing children, and all of them just swarmed to her. It's her warmth.
She's driven, she knows what she wants. In such a lovely, caring manner, so I think for me that's why she's exceptional.
From this apprenticeship, it helps me what I'm wanting to do for my future, which is working with deaf children.
I'm Milo Mitchell. I've completed my foundation apprenticeship in business skills. I am now an intellectual capital assistant at Bailey Gifford. My apprenticeship has clearly helped me decide what I would like to do next. It's provided the business world down to a digestible size where I could easily access all the tools I need to execute my career.
I think the things that make Milo good are he's very confident, he's very willing to learn and also to throw himself in at the deep end and get involved with the work of the team.
What made Milo a good apprentice was his willingness to learn.
his ability to absorb ideas, processes, to reflect, and to then apply the new skills that he'd learned.
I think the apprenticeship was an eye-opener for me. The experience was so valuable.
I'm Harley Higgins. I just recently finished my foundation apprenticeship and I'm now a modern apprentice at Agreco. So during my foundation apprenticeship, it covers a lot of different sectors, so everything from learning report writing to IT skills to lathe work to communication, a really wide range of stuff.
Yeah, FAs are so important for organisations because it lets the young people gain valuable skills, not only the academic ability, but also those practical skills that employers are really looking out for in young people.
We're so proud of Harley at West College Scotland. His confidence has grown so much. Yeah, he was a wee bit shy to start with, but throughout the process we've just seen him grow from strength to strength.
Harley's really developed through his apprenticeship from the first day he came in to what he is now. The change has been massive. He's like a sponge with any learning that he wants to know everything.
I felt really, really good when I got my apprenticeship. Agreco was the one that I had my heart set on and I was really, really happy.
And the winner of Foundation Apprentice of the Year is Harley Higgins.
Recognised at the Scottish Apprenticeship Awards, it does feel really, really, really good because I think you get out what you put in to the FA. If you put in 100% effort and you're really, really focused on it and it's something you are truly passionate about, you'll get so, so much value from it.
Up next is the award for Modern Apprentice of the Year at SCQF Level 5, which is sponsored by Scotland's Apprentice Network. Let's find out who made the finalist shortlist.
My name is Alex Rutenbergs and I'm a modern apprentice for Glasgow City Council. I arrived in Scotland when I was 12, with no English. I didn't know anything about friends and going out. All I knew is how to work. I always wanted to do gardening because it's outside and you always learn new stuff every day. I got a talent for this through my Asperger's because it makes me focus on the job at hand, and the environment is so colourful. When I started, had to use this to help me through my challenges of anxiety and stress.
He's very punctual, he's very willing to do any task. He works well and he has great skill set in terms of practical skills.
I'm finding happiness through the apprenticeship. My apprenticeship changed my life. I don't need this quite so much now.
I'm Julianne Murray, I'm a farm worker in a modern apprenticeship. I work for INP Johnson here in Shetland. It was definitely something I always wanted to do. I love working with sheep, but I love farms, so definitely something I wanted to do.
As a young woman, there was very few women in agriculture. And when Julianne came and asked if I would take her on, I just thought it was something to give back to somebody in the community. It's hard to find apprenticeships up here.
We've actually taken a lot out of the apprenticeship, as this is the first time we've ever done it. As we move into a new generation of farming, which is zero emissions or less emissions, all that kind of things we've built into the apprenticeship along with Julianne.
The kind of work I do really depends on what time of year it is. Like right now, then it's mostly just feeding sheep inside and outside, make sure everything is as it should be. Any illnesses or whatnot is taken care of. I've changed a lot in my apprenticeship. It's given me so much confidence. My apprenticeship has definitely made me confirm I want to be in agriculture and work in agriculture. I've done it all my life, it's what I want to keep doing.
My name's Lewis Patterson. I'm a modern apprentice from the Wheatley Group. The kind of work I do is challenging, but it's also a learning curve. In the morning, we will usually start with the closes, and then in the afternoon, if it's not too bad and we've done the closes, we will go out and do grass cutting and winter maintenance. As a person in my apprenticeship, I have developed probably to the highest standards of myself, timekeeping, management, and also confidence boosting myself.
Lewis is one of the best apprentices. Like I said, I've worked with apprentices now for 9 years, and by far stands out for the rest. Seeing the way he is now, like I said, it's genuinely inspiring, and he's going to go on and hopefully do well within our organisation.
Before this, I really had nothing, to be honest with you, left school with nothing, but when I came in here, the people around me have been so supportive and helped me and building me up. As a person, I've changed so much, and I just can't thank everybody for helping me do it.
And the winner of Modern Apprentice of the Year at SCQF Level 5 is Julie Ann Murray.
I never thought I'd be recognised for the Scottish Apprentice Award. Like, it's unbelievable, I can't believe it.
Next up is the award for Modern Apprentice of the Year at SEQF Level 6 or above. This category is sponsored by the Scottish Training Federation, so let's see who the finalists are.
I'm Billy Witherspoon. I am an IT administrator and I was a modern apprentice with EGG Lighting. IT is something that I've always wanted to do, especially from a young age. I always had a knack for fixing computers, helping people. In my apprenticeship, I mainly helped out users and maintained systems in EGG Lighting that allowed the company to function more effectively.
Billy is a fantastic apprentice for many reasons. His tenacity stands out to me. He's also shows real capacity to absorb new information and learn.
I'm more confident and I'm more willing to kind of get involved.
I am Conor Colburn, I'm a joiner and I was a modern apprentice for Orkney Builders. My dad has always worked in like the industry, so then I went to work with him when I was a kid and I just enjoyed it. The work we kind of do is we build kits from start to finish, so put the kit up, roof on, plasterboard, partitions up, and then back onto the finishings, kitchens and everything. So I get involved with most of that all the way through. Even if it's different houses, at least you get to do it.
Connor's a good apprentice because he's hardworking, enthusiastic and always up for a challenge. You get a bit of crack with him and he's always a bit of humour with him, so it's a bit of banter on site. So.
I had to earn the trust when I first started because you're obviously just a young lad who's not much experience, nothing. Be able to be left by yourself and actually people allow you to do stuff and not constantly checking your work or whatever. So it makes you feel good. Like ever since I was young, working with my dad. So this is always what I wanted to do.
I'm Missy Ann Spence and I'm a personal relationship manager and modern apprentice for Lloyds Banking Group. So in my apprenticeship, the work that I actually do is modules. So we work through a curriculum, which we also do within a school setting. So it correlates with the job that I do in terms of customer service, allowing me to bring those skill sets together and work on the modules within my own role. Since the apprenticeship, I've changed significantly within my personal life. Again, it's a drive. I'm watching my children see me go through the apprenticeship and the smiles on their faces, and just the admiration for two small children to see what can be done by mum has given me the drive to keep going, keep succeeding to the point I've now taken up another apprenticeship within the bank.
Missy is a fantastic apprentice because she comes in with a positive attitude every single day, has the knowledge behind her and the confidence to implement the skills that she's learned.
To a young person thinking about becoming an apprentice, I would say go for it. Your path is your path, no one else's.
I'm thrilled to announce that the winner of Modern Apprentice of the Year at SCQF Level 6 or above is Billy Witherspoon.
I'd like to thank Elliot Richardson for helping me throughout my apprenticeship and helping me learn how to interact with others and gain more confidence.
Our penultimate award is for Graduate Apprentice of the Year, which is generously sponsored by Scottish Funding Council. Graduate apprenticeships are helping thousands of people across Scotland to work, earn and learn up to master's degree level. Let's meet our three talented finalists.
I'm Gaurav Suresh and I'm a software engineering graduate apprentice working at BBC Scotland. My plans were just to go to a traditional university, get a software engineering degree, but in fifth year a person actually came and talked to our school and I really liked the idea of working and studying at the same time. The kind of work that I do at the BBC is actually working on the critical broadcast and scheduling systems behind the TV and radio output that you see every day. I've developed immensely over these past few years. I've been able to develop the confidence professionally to network and really take the initiative and to do what I want.
So something we're really looking for in our engineering teams is a sense of openness and collaboration and someone who's really up to the challenge, and Gaurav evidenced that immediately, and over the last few years we've just seen him grow and grow and grow, and he's a remarkable young man.
I'm delighted to be shortlisted for the Scottish Apprenticeship Awards. I've put in a lot of hard work and it's amazing to be recognised for my efforts.
I'm Fatima Asif and I'm a graduate apprentice year 3 for Plexus Corp. I think when I first started, I was fresh out of school, so it was very, very daunting working in industry, especially because for me the stakes were high, it was what I wanted to do. I was so, so glad that I got it. And I think over the apprenticeship, I've developed, you know, being sure in myself. So I think that's definitely the biggest thing that I've developed in, and it's being sure in myself.
So Fatima from the start was really gregarious in her approach. She's come on leaps and bounds. She's able to fully engage with people at all different levels of the organisation, from the senior leadership team right to the people at the coalface and the operators on the floor.
Proud, successful and confident, that's how I feel about doing this apprenticeship.
I'm Anna Solek. I'm a graduate apprentice software engineer for JP Morgan Chase. I'm a web developer, so I write programmes for websites and I'm also involved in a lot of user experience and design. Since starting my apprenticeship, I would say I've changed so much professionally, but also like as a person, and my confidence has improved so much through all the work I do.
The value that Anna brings to her team, I can't really put into words. She brings fresh perspective, she brings enthusiasm, and she's always coming up with new and exciting ideas for the rest of the team. I regularly joke with her that one day she will be my boss.
I feel a great deal of pride being able to influence so many people around the world with the work I do for JP Morgan. It's an amazing opportunity to get so early on.
And the winner of Graduate Apprentice of the Year is Fatima Asif.
I think it's always really nice to feel that recognition for your hard work and effort, and I think to know that I've gotten that, it makes me feel really, really good.
Wow, what a tremendous group of winners and finalists, and huge thanks again to Jennifer Colonco for supporting this year's awards. But now we have come to the big finale, the moment you have all been waiting for, as we find out which of our Foundation, Modern and Graduate Apprentice winners will be named the overall Apprentice of the Year. To announce our final winner and Scotland's Apprentice of the Year, I am delighted to hand over to a special guest.
Hello, I hope you're having a great awards ceremony so far. These awards are a great opportunity to recognise the vital work of apprentices as well as the valuable support of employers and learning providers who enable apprentices to succeed. Well done to all of the winners and finalists tonight. You have all achieved so much and should be thoroughly proud of your achievements. It is my pleasure to announce the winner of Scotland's Apprentice of the Year. Only one person can be named such, and these awards are always very competitive, and this year was no exception. This individual has shown exceptional determination, commitment and a real love for their dream job. Their apprenticeship has made a huge difference to them and their career, as well as bringing benefits to their employer, all while developing and retaining key skills in the local community, showing apprenticeships are unlocking potential across Scotland. I'm therefore delighted to announce that Scotland's Apprentice of the Year is Julianne Murray from INP Johnson in Shetland. Well done and congratulations, Julianne.
Huge congratulations to Julianne on your double award win. Incredible. And a massive well done to every one of our winners and finalists. Your achievements are absolutely brilliant and you should be so, so proud. A very special thank you to everyone who has made this year's awards possible, from our nominators and judges to our guest speakers, generous sponsors, and of course, every one of you for tuning in and joining us. Thank you so much. We really hope you enjoyed the show. In fact, keep the celebrations going by sharing your comments below or by shouting about the awards on social media using the hashtag ScotAtAwards. Thank you so much for joining us and take care. Thank you.